Today's Midday Kentucky Cooking segment brought to you by Creative Kitchen and Bath, where you will always cook in style.
Hi there, welcome back to Midday Kentucky. Chef Allison Davis here in the Wild Thyme Kitchen, and I'm cooking up some Easter recipes this week. Lamb is kind of one of the most popular dishes for the holiday, but I'm always thinking about things that would pair well with that. So the first thing I'm doing is what I consider a show-stopping side, and this is going to be kind of a potato gratin with leeks and fresh herbs and garlic. And you know, when you have fresh herbs, garlic, leeks, and potatoes, it really can't be bad. So what I'm starting with is I'm just chopping up some leeks here. I've got some butter melting in our skillet. And we're going to get this sauteing off with some garlic. And we're going to just keep kind of building our flavors in this pan. And leeks are probably one of my all-time favorites. If you're not familiar with them and you haven't used them in the past, I really encourage you to do so, because they just have a little bit more flavor than an onion. They just work. They just have such great flavor. All right, mincing a little bit of garlic here, and that's going to go in with our leeks. And then we've got a little bit of fresh thyme. Just for convenience, I'm going to just throw this in just so that we can get the infusion of the thyme flavor, and then we can just pull those out before we add them in with our potatoes. All right, I've got our garlic here going in, just a little nice rough chop, and we're just sauteing this in a little bit of butter on about a medium heat. Now for your potatoes, you can slice them, or you could also use a mandolin, which is just a tool that helps you to do thin slices. I just know that it's probably the most dangerous tool with people at home, because they're just not as familiar and the blade is super sharp. So if you feel comfortable, you know, just slicing your potato like so, you just want to do that about kind of a half an inch to a quarter of an inch thick. So we're just slicing our potatoes. I'm using a Yukon Gold potato. You could use an Idaho potato if you like, but Yukon Golds, I think, just are more buttery, more rich, and just have a much better consistency and texture, especially when they're baked. All right, if you guys could smell this right now. All right, we've got a little salt and pepper in here, and our fresh thyme is working. So really, at this point, we're just going to kind of build our sauce. So we're going to add a bit of cream into our leeks. Again, how could this be bad? We've got cream, we've got leeks, we have garlic, and then we're going to make it even better because we're going to add some cheese. So I've got two different types of cheese that I'm going to add into this one. I've got smoked Gouda, which is one of my favorites, and then some fresh Parmesan. So I'm going to add some Parmesan into this. It's going to help kind of thicken our sauce. And then we're going to layer this beauty, and we are going to put it in the oven at 400, let it go for about 30 minutes, and I'm going to show you guys how this works. All right, so we layered our potatoes, we poured our cream mixture into the layers, we put some cheese in between, and then seasoned it with salt and pepper. We let this bake for about, I'd say, 20 minutes, and just to get our potatoes nice and soft, and then I'm going to just take this, oh, looks heavenly. We're going to layer this up, and then I will, you know, probably just garnish it with a little bit of fresh thyme as well. But again, this is going to make for a delicious side dish for the holidays. Even if you wanted to take a little spoon and kind of spoon some of this sauce right over the top, I don't know how anybody is going to disagree with this dish. All right, little garnish, and you're good to go. You guys know where to find this recipe. You can go to middaykentucky.com/recipes tab, and you can click on this one and many others. I'm Chef Allison Davis. You can find me on Instagram, and you can visit us at wildthymecooking.com. We'll be right back after this short break.